Good morning and welcome to United First Parish Church. Whoever you are, whomever you love, wherever you are on your journey, welcome to our Unitarian Universalist spiritual community. Thank you for joining us online as we continue our weekly services designed to bring our worship to you and to keep our congregation and community connected and engaged. I should let you know that we will be recording this service so that we can post it for people who weren't able to join us now. So at this time, we ask for you to make sure that your microphone and cameras are off. This will help this whole process work more smoothly. We'll invite you to turn them back on later in the service for joys and sorrows. I'm Jamie Grassman. I'm the chair of the worship committee, and today I'm your worship associate. Our senior minister, Reverend Rebecca Froom, is still on sabbatical. Today, Reverend Beau Rivers will be giving our readings and homily. I extend a special welcome to those of you who are guests or feeling new to our community. If this is one of your first times with us this morning, and if you feel comfortable, I invite you to go to ufpc.org, our website, and let us know how we can contact you and if you have any questions we can answer. And thank you for joining us today.
Good morning. How good it is to be with you again. I've missed you these past two Sundays. I want to wish all who parent a happy Mother's Day. Our opening words are by Gretchen Haley. We gather today to surrender to the mystery, to release ourselves from the need to know, the longing to have it all figured out. The burden of believing either everything or nothing is within our control. And in that moment of surrender, we make space for a new breath, a new healing, a new possibility, the courage we find in peace. May it be so.
Today, as we light our chalice, the symbol of our Unitarian Universalist faith, I am going to share words by Claudine Oliva. We light our chalice this morning as tribute to the mothers in each of us. We celebrate those who take on the task of raising a baby through childhood, adolescence, and adulthood. We celebrate those who nurture the light of truth and compassion in growing minds and hearts. We celebrate those who commit time, money, talent, and energy to the children of this world. And we give thanks to the source of all life, the one who gave us birth and sustenance, our great mother, Earth, and the circle of life of which we are a part. Will you please join me in reading our covenant? You will see the words printed on the screen. As a free fellowship of this historic church, we unite to lift our hearts and open our minds to a larger reality, to accept, support, and encourage one another, to seek the wisdom in all religions, to cherish and sustain the web of life, and to strive for justice, compassion, and peace. You join me in singing this hymn for the beauty of the earth.
Oh, friend and mindfulness instructor recently told me that breath is the one thing that signals to your body that it's alive. Every day we breathe in and out about 25,000 times. Breath is our superpower because it can help us to relieve stress and anger, generate energy and motivation, or soothe ourselves when we're feeling blue. This morning, I'm going to share two breathing techniques found in the book, Breathe With Me, Using Breath to Feel Strong, Calm, and Happy by Miriam Gates. And although this is a children's book, the techniques are useful for everybody. So if you're tired in the morning and it's hard to get out of bed, use rainbow breath to wake up and get your body moving. If everybody sits up and lets your spine grow tall, and you bring your arms out straight to the sides, palm down, then you inhale, sweeping your arms up over your head, palm to palm, and then exhale, bringing your arms back out straight, palms down. Let's do that three times. Inhale and sweep your arms up over your head, palm to palm. Exhale and bring your arms back straight down to your sides, palms down. Inhale and sweep your arms up over your head. Exhale, bring your arms straight back down, palms down. Inhale, sweeping your arms up over your head, palms to palm. Exhale, and bring your arms back straight down, palms down. Notice how that makes your body feel right now. Sometimes we feel unsure or anxious or worried about things that are happening in our life, and dandelion breath can be used to make you feel calm and at ease. And if you think about a dandelion, and maybe when you were a kid you used to pick them and the flower was gone and it was just the seed pods waiting, and you would blow the seeds and they would fly out in front of you. So if you close your eyes and you think of that. So take a deep breath in and then blow out slowly, sending those seeds into the air. Take a deep breath in and then blow out, sending those seeds out into the air. Take a deep breath in and blow out, sending those seeds into the air. Notice how that makes your body feel. I've shared two techniques from the book, Breathe With Me, by Miriam Gates. And you can listen to the whole book online. I've put a link on the religious education page on our website.
We drink from wells we did not dig, and we sit in the shade of trees we did not plant. As recipients of all we have received from those who came before us, we are called to share our abundance with those who will follow us. This congregation aspires to do life-affirming and life-transforming work, both for those of us who gather with in our online church and for the larger web of life of which we are a part. As a voluntary association, our church is sustained through the gifts of its members and friends of the congregation. Your generosity will keep the lights on in the church when we get back into it, our gardens watered. Your generosity sustains the lifespan religious program. Your generosity supports a liberal religious voice in our greater community. These social distancing measures that we are practicing have fundamentally changed the way we must perform our offertory. Please take this moment to visit our website and consider clicking on the donate button located on the homepage of our website, ufpc.org, to support the good works of United First Parish Church. Let us open our hearts as these gifts are joyfully given and gratefully received. I do have some announcements. This week, Joe McDonald will be doing a parents check-in on Tuesday night at 8 o'clock. And on Friday at 2:30, she's doing a Community Connect workshop also on Zoom. She'll be emailing out links for those meetings. Next week, May 17th, we have Greg Greenway and hopefully Reggie Harris will be our guest ministers and musicians for the service. I want to thank Clyde Courtright for stepping up to be worship associate next week. Thank you very much. The week after that, we're having a service based on the animals that share our lives. Christopher Patrick Taylor and I will be co-hosting this. And we look forward to receiving photographs of the animals that are near and dear to you. And if you're willing, maybe you could share a story as well. You can contact me. I'll email, again, an email address for me and for Christopher so that you can send that material to us. I'm sorry, Bo, did you have an announcement as well?
I don't, other than the Wednesday group will be meeting at its usual time at 2 o'clock. Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you. This morning's service is full of surprises. Each week, we take time to share our important joys and sorrows so all of us might help carry the burden and join in the celebration. If you wish to acknowledge a sorrow or joy from your heart, I invite you to raise your hand and unmute your mic when we call you by name. We begin our time of sharing by lighting a candle. Last night, I received a phone call from a member of the Brainerd family, letting us know that Bob Brainerd had passed away on Wednesday night. He was in the presence of family. Bob has been a member of UFPC for over 30 years, and he'd been living in a nursing home with COPD and congestive heart failure. He was 104 years old. We keep Bob and all who loved him in our hearts and prayers. I light this last candle for all that remains unspoken in our hearts. For all that is spoken and unspoken, let us take a moment of silent meditation and prayer. Spirit of love, we lift up those whose loved ones are dying in quarantine. and for birthday anniversaries of loved ones who have passed, who touched our hearts deeply. We give thanks for new job opportunities and for elders who are doing well in the midst of this COVID crisis. And for book groups that come together and invite authors to share their experience of writing the book. Let us give thanks. Let us be at peace with our bodies and our minds. Let us return to ourselves and become wholly ourselves. Let us be aware of the source of being, common to us all and to all living things. Evoking the presence of the great compassion, let us fill our hearts with our own compassion toward ourselves and toward all living things. With humility and appreciation for the gift of life, and with awareness of the suffering around us, let us practice the establishment of peace in our hearts and on this earth. My teleprompt app has frozen, so I'll be reading slightly lower than usual rather than looking at you directly. My colleague, the Reverend Meg Barnhouse, tells the story of a time when she was driving along a mountainous back road and came up fast behind a slow-moving flatbed pickup truck. In the back of the truck is a farmer holding a goat. And the goat is standing stiff-legged while the farmer is talking to it. The goat tries to look over to the side of the truck, but seeing the ground whizzing by is no comfort. The farmer keeps whispering in the goat's ear until slowly the goat folds its legs, sits on the farmer's lap, and with eyes closed, lifts its head into the breeze. Totally relaxed. How many times have we been the goat in the back of a pickup truck? Outside our natural element, wondering if we are on our way to greener pastures or to the slaughterhouse. If we do hear a soft voice telling us to relax, we can't be sure if it's coming from some benevolent god or the goat meat factory. When uncertainty begins to undermine our overall sense of well-being, one way to parent ourselves is to discern what is within our control and what is not. Clearly, the goat in our story was not in the driver's seat. Once we let go of what is beyond our control, we can focus on how we respond to it by bringing our attention to the breath. In a stressful situation, we might notice how our breath has become rapid, shallow, or constricted. And today we learned that when we expand and regulate the breath, we're able to restore a sense of inner peace. Like the farmer who whispers sweet nothings in our ear, we stop worrying about the future and settle into the peace of the present moment. In many religious traditions, the breath represents the vehicle through which we experience the indwelling spirit of life. According to the Encyclopedia of Religions, in many languages, the words for soul, spirit, wind, and breath all share the same etymology. In Latin, for example, spiritus comes from the word spirare, which means to breathe. And in Greek, there are two words for soul, psyche, which means to breathe or to blow, and anima, which means to draw up. In Hebrew, the word ruach means wind, or breath of life with which God created the world. In Chinese, the word for spirit is qi, which also means breath. And in Sanskrit, the word Atman means soul, and the word prana means life force. Both are derivatives from the root word an, which means the ability to breathe. Joe Landwehr, author of The Association of the Embodied Soul with Breath, tells us, "The breath is the basis of all spiritual disciplines that promote a direct relationship between the body and spirit. These practices include various forms of meditation, yoga, circular breathing, moving meditations such as Qigong and Tai Chi, and certain Sufi practices. Even Gregorian chanting is a form of conscious breathing." So I invite us now to take a few deep breaths together. Perhaps dandelion breath, or rainbow breath, or some other breath you might be familiar with, and allow ourselves to surrender our worries and experience a moment of inner peace.
Loosen, baby, you don't have to carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, let go, let go. Loosen, baby, you don't have to carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, let go, let go. Holy breath and holy name, will you ease this pain? Holy breath and holy name, will you ease this pain? Loosen, baby, and you don't have to carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, pain. Loosen, baby, and you don't have to carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, pain. Loosen, baby, and hold holy carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, loosen, baby, and hold holy carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go. Loosen, baby, and hold holy carry the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go, the weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go. The weight of the world in your muscles and bones. Let go.
In the words of Vi Keelan and Randy Armstrong, fear does not stop death, it stops life. And worrying does not take away tomorrow's troubles. It takes away today's peace. May we allow ourselves to succumb to that inner peace. And for our closing music, we have "Because You Loved Me" by Celine Dion.
For all those times you stood by me, for all the truth that you made me see, for all the joy you brought to my life, for all the wrong that you made right, for every dream you made come true, for all the love I found in you, I'll be forever thankful, baby. You're the one who held me up, never let me fall. You're the one who saw me through, through it all. You were my strength when I was weak. You were my
Wiley, could we have the next slide? Thank you. May we find peace in these uncertain times, and like the goat in the back of a pickup truck, may we have the wisdom to know when to relax, lift our heads, and let our ears flap in the breeze. May it be so.